My name is Erik Ron, and I'm a producer, writer, mixer, engineer, dog owner, and Cleveland sports fan. So I did work for a while for John Feldman. It was a really crazy experience. It was the first time I got to work with like super, super marquee artists in the rock genre, where I was given the keys to actually do my thing, and they listened to me because I was working under him. And it was a great experience to get a real intimate relationship with an artist like Panic at the Disco or something, where we could have a real experience where before I couldn't have just gotten in the room with someone like that. It was a great kickstart for my credits, for people to actually take me more serious. Before I worked for John Feldman, I worked at a private studio in Woodland Hills for about 4 years, where I really got to like cut my teeth and learn a lot about gear I never had access to before and artists that I could never work with before. So it was a little bit of a stepping stone. So I was already prepared by the time I got that gig. I mean, for me to get the client list that I got, it was one artist at a time. I think the most important thing was to not try to look so far ahead and to not get stressed out over things I couldn't control. Before labels really paid attention to me, I had to build something special. And that's what everyone told me. I was a little bit reluctant to listen to that right away, but really, it started with a band called I the Mighty. I discovered them on the internet. I went to a show at the Roxy, I met the manager, and we built a bond, and I had them come into the studio, and we banged out 3 songs. They got signed right away, and that was kind of the catalyst to everything. So it really just took one, and then I just kept going and kept going. It's just like one after another after another. It just, for me, it wasn't like an overnight success. It took years and years of one thing at a time. And word of mouth is everything. There's no advertisements, you know, it really just takes word of mouth and people to spread the music. It has to live through the music, and that's it. So I think what separates myself from just a regular producer is I do have a lot of involvement with writing, and I think that's what people come to me for, is it's more of just a creative force in the project. I mean, I try to become a band member who just happens to also produce the project. I think it really helps me because I'm really invested in. And it doesn't mean that I don't care about projects that I just produce, because that's my job too. And if the writing doesn't need to happen, then it doesn't need to happen. And so I don't force it on people, but if they tag me in, I want to go in as a band member. I don't want to take it all over. And if they want me to do melodies, I'll do melodies, but most people want me for me. And I think that's really important, is to establish your identity, establish what your strengths are, what your weaknesses are. And I mean, obviously, none of us want weaknesses, but you have to try to show your client that this is what you do. And if you tag me in, like, I'm going to do it for you. And I'm grateful that you tagged me in. Let's go. Let's all make great art. I would say one of the most fun albums I've been a part of is the Siler album Seasons that just came out a couple months ago. Those are boys of mine, and we just have a really, really great time. And it's real. We're emotional. If we're having a bad day, we talk about it. And we also know how to party. And so it was just a blast. It's fun doing R&B elements, fun doing rock elements, trap elements, hip hop. So I have a lot of fun when I can really stretch out and not just go into one little box. And when you love the people that you're making music with, that's the dream. That's a dream, is to make music with people you love. So Siler, I love you boys. Shout out. I know you're like me, oh.